Inside this video, we are going to be working with the bootcamp zip number 3. So let's move that folder inside this folder, because we are going to probably unzip the folder so we can find the solution. Make a full selection in here, unselect the zip 3 and delete. Then, just in case, let's right click 7-zip and extract here. I mean, because I don't know what problem we are going to have in here. Let me go back in here and double check that I already uninstalled the template from my last video. Let's go and unselect, make selection on this one, whatever other template you have in there. Then let's go to extensions, you know what, let's go to manage in here. Make a selection on the template and click uninstall. Then let's go to install and click on browse and upload the bootcamp number 3. Click open, upload and install, and as you can see, we don't have the template thumbnail. Well, the file does not exist, okay? So let's go back in here. If you analyze everything, you are going to be able to see the thumbnail in here. So what is going on, okay? Now, I want you to keep in mind, if you analyze all this very quickly, believe me, sometimes you are not going to be able to see the error in here, and especially the errors that are going to be really simple to understand. That happens, believe me. I have been troubleshooting a simple error that took me days until I find out that the problem was only a misspelling. So if you analyze in here, template thumbnail, okay? And then if you go back in here, you are going to have the template thumbnail. But what is wrong with that? Well, right now the template thumbnail won't be the right file name. Why? Because you are going to have the extra S inside here. So what you will need to do is eliminate the S, and down here eliminate the S in there. There you have it. Now we are going to double check the template details. Let me go in here and probably click file, open and file. Then make a selection on the template details. There we are. And double check that the thumbnail will be in here and the preview will be in here with the right name. So everything seems fine now. We are going to make a full selection, unselect the bootcamp 3, right click 7-zip and add to testing. There we go. Let's go back to the installation, click on browse and testing one more time. Click open and upload and install. There we go. Let's go to extensions, template manager, and make the template default. Click on make default and click on view site. There you are. As you can see, the problem was a misspelling inside the template details. Now, a misspelling could happen either inside the template details in here or inside the files, okay? So you will need to be careful while creating a new template in Joomla. Let me just make a full selection in here, delete, yes, and for this video, you know what, let me go back very quickly and uninstall, click in here, and make default that template. Then go back to extensions and extension manager. I am just going to uninstall the template very quickly so I can go ahead and start the next video. Click in here and uninstall. So my friends, for this video that will be it, and let's move on to the next one.